That was in the 16-button boot days, and the caller's name was Pearl. All her buttons were diamonds. The ladies of the ballet were always the most controversial. I can always remember Tessie with the wonderful hair. It was not golden, but it was hanging down her back. In the front row were two beautiful girls, Miss Alice Dunning, afterwards celebrated, particularly in the States, as Miss Alice Dunning Lingard, Mrs. Horace Lingard, and Miss Wilson, subsequently known to fame as Lardy Wilson. And then there were the fans, the men who loitered around the performers. Actresses were the only women, along with prostitutes, with whom men could have a natural conversation, unhampered by the purdah created by society's conventions. They were the only women that they could playfully get to know. Some men found this compelling. Fans would come multiple nights, sometimes every night, hanging around backstage after the performance, offering to provide their carriages to transport actresses to and from work, or their other theatrical commitments. They'd take them for supper, to exclusive private rooms, often little select parties. Sometimes the more attractive and charming actresses would be taken to balls and mix in the higher circles of politicians, businessmen and aristocrats, the ton, although they were never befriended by any of the upper-class ladies. Gifts of expensive clothes or jewellery were the perks of the job. Access to the lady performers was granted according to the size of a gentleman's wallet or their position in society. Only the most influential got to linger in the wings during the performances. The eminent Victorian theatre critic, Clement Scott, was of the belief that it is nearly impossible for a woman to remain pure who adopts the stage as a profession. There is no school on earth so bad for the formation of character.